Today's installment in this Brand Experience Week covers two e-commerce brands that have branched out into brick-and-mortar stores, Bonobos and Warby Parker. These brands provide learnings for other e-commerce companies and really all retail stores. Both brands use their stores to provide the excellent personal service that people who know them online would appreciate, but they both have a way to go before their stores truly embody their brands and attract new customers. Let's start with Bonobos. Bonobos was founded in 2007 as a website to address men's aversion to shopping. It started offering, quote, the best fitting pants you've ever owned, and eventually expanded to a full range of menswear and accessories. In 2011, the company started opening guide shops, brick and mortar locations where customers can get fitted and pick out styles and colors, and then have their purchases shipped to them. Bonobos currently runs 10 guide shops, and I checked out the one in San Francisco. Now, you really have to be seeking out the store because the location is only identifiable by a banner hanging from the fire escape above a nondescript looking building. And you see the Bonobos name only after you enter the building. Once you take the elevator to the second floor, you're greeted by a friendly chalkboard sign, which is really the only signage in the entire store. The space feels more like a merchant showroom than a retail store. A beautiful magalong was available, but otherwise there was very little branding. The vibe is very laid back, with rap music playing over the PA and salespeople wearing flip-flops. There's a console equipped with a computer, but it's unclear if customers are supposed to use it and what for. The experience is very high-touch and not designed to be self-serve, so you're out of luck if you're there when the couple of salespeople are tied up with other customers. Your best bet is to make an appointment, which about half of the customers do. Warby Parker is an eyewear brand that also started exclusively online. Warby Parker's mission is to create boutique-quality, classically crafted eyewear at a revolutionary price point. It has attracted customers through an easy try-and-buy experience, as well as its cool glasses designs. It currently runs 3 stores and 6 so-called showrooms, which are locations in other boutique retail stores. I visited the store in New York, which was operated out of the front of its corporate office, because they're working on a new location. I got the sense it was pretty representative of the Warby Parker brand experience nonetheless. Like Bonobos, you really have to be looking for the store to find it. There is no signage on the exterior, and only a laser-printed sign greets you as you step off the elevator. It also isn't intended as a self-serve experience. Again, there are a couple of computers at the front, but it isn't clear what you should do with them. The products aren't clearly labeled for men or women, and there's no signage to explain what, if any, options are available. There's a bunch of stock behind the register which suggests that you might be able to take your glasses home with you, but the purchase process isn't clear. And the two salespeople who were manning the store when I visited were busy serving other customers. So once again, I was out of luck. There are fun decorative items at the entrance and more inspired displays, but it's pretty streamlined, just like the Bonobo store. Missing from both stores is a digitally enhanced experience that many retailers are now offering. There's no obvious way to use the internet or wireless to get more product information, share images or comments on social media, or to check online for prices, pricing options, or inventory. Also missing is brand personality and cues of brand values and attributes. Both companies have built their online customer franchises through strong brand values. Warby Parker donates a pair of glasses for every pair that's purchased. And Bonobo stands out because of its distinctive tone and manner that appeals to male sensibilities. But neither of the retail spaces convey a strong sense of brand, which is key to attracting and keeping new customers. So that's my report on e-commerce brands going brick and mortar. Hope you're enjoying these brand experience briefs. Look out for tomorrow's video, which compares the retail stores that two food manufacturers have opened, Chobani and Dannon.